This video demonstrates how you can administer secure exams from Google Classroom using ChromEx. We are now in Google Classroom from the perspective of a teacher. Assuming the ChromEx Chrome plugin has been installed manually or sent out automatically to teachers by a domain administrator, you will see this button in Google Classroom. Exams can now be created using a familiar process, similar to creating messages, assignments, and questions. Since we are in an existing classroom course, ChromEx knows which students and teachers are in the class and automatically assigns them to the exam. Choose a title for the exam, together with a course code or basic instructions. The start time for the exam determines when the student can start the exam. After the end time has passed, the student is unable to start an exam. Based on teacher feedback, we have made it possible for students to continue a current exam after the end time has passed. The teacher has the ability to extend the exam time if needed. Next, we have the ability to increase security by adding a PIN code for starting, resuming, and submitting exams. You can enable submissions using Safe Exam Browser for ChromEx running on Windows and Mac OS X. To increase security, you are required to use a Restore Exam PIN code. If you enable exam submission via the URL student.chromex.io, the exam submission is treated as insecure. In this case, responsibility for securing the exam environment lies with the school. Mobile management tools can be used to increase security. The option to administer an anonymous exam is unavailable for exams created in Google Classroom. If you are interested in administering anonymous exams, please watch the video by clicking on the link in the top right-hand corner of the page. Under the Students and Teachers tab, I can add or remove individuals. Under the Resources tab, I can add exam information and questions. Resources supported by ChromEx are now visible. ChromEx currently supports a wide range of resources, with more to be added in the coming months. I will now add some resource examples. The exam is now ready, and an assignment has been created in Google Classroom. The start time of the exam has also been added to the student's Google Calendar. To finish, let us return to Google Classroom where we left off, either by clicking on the Classroom shortcut or by selecting the Open Classroom tab. Now that the exam is scheduled, we're ready to take a look at the exam from the student's perspective in the next video.